Why do some crypto skyrocket while others just, well, flop? The answer usually comes down to something called tokenomics. Yep, it's like the economics of a token. Today, we're breaking down what tokenomics is and why it matters, all in super simple terms. What is tokenomics? Which elements form a full tokenomics? I guess these are two things you want to know most, but watch till the end of this video. We'll have a special part about how to spot a good tokenomics of a project, so you can master something useful for your future investment decisions. All right, so what exactly is tokenomics? Imagine you're setting up a game, and you're deciding how many points players can earn, what they can spend those points on, and how to keep everyone playing fairly. Tokenomics is kinda like that, but for crypto. It's the game plan for how many tokens users can get, how they're distributed, and what they're actually used for. These are also the key elements that form a full tokenomics. Check our part 2 of the video now to know more details about each element and how they affect the way people evaluate a tokenomics. The first thing that we should notice when checking the tokenomics of a project is the supply. Think of it like a limited edition sneaker. Some coins, like Bitcoin. The world only has 21 million Bitcoin, to be exact. Just like those rare kicks, when there's a limit, people see it as more valuable. On the other hand, some tokens are like everyday sneakers you can find in any store. They just keep making more and more. Those tokens might not hold their value as well over time because, well, they're everywhere. However, having a set supply isn't the only thing that makes a token valuable. Let's talk about purpose, or as we like to call it, utility. Generally, what can you do with a token? Think of it like this. A token with purpose is like a carnival ticket. You can trade it in for games, food, or rides. Others are just for show, kinda like collecting rare coins or tokens. They look cool, but you don't actually use them for anything. Tokens with a clear purpose often have a better shot at being valuable in the long term. Aside from having a purpose, some tokens go the extra mile to keep people interested. Let's talk about the rewards we can get when holding that kind of token. Many projects offer perks just for holding onto their tokens, like earning interest or getting bonus tokens. It's like a loyalty card at your favorite coffee shop. The more you use it, the more you get rewarded. These rewards make people want to keep the token instead of selling it right away, which helps keep the token's value steady and builds loyalty. Even with rewards, you want to ensure that the token is spread out fairly. Let's talk about distribution. Distribution is all about who holds the tokens and how many tokens they can have maximum. Imagine if, at a bake sale, one person grabbed 90% of the cookies to sell. Kinda unfair, right? In the same way, if one group or a person holds most of the tokens, they can mess with the price whenever they want. Good tokenomics means tokens are spread out more evenly, so it's fairer for everyone and makes the project more trustworthy. So, how do you spot a project with good tokenomics? Here's the cheat. Look for tokens with a clear purpose, a balanced supply, and rewards that keep people engaged. And if you notice one group holding a huge chunk of tokens, that's usually a red flag. Projects with solid, well-balanced tokenomics are often the ones that survive in the long run. Seed's listing is around the corner. Understanding these basics can help you make the most of it. What are you hoping for in Seed tokenomics? Drop a comment with your thoughts, and don't forget to subscribe to Seed Combinator for more easy-to-understand crypto guides and the latest updates on Seed.